Welcome to Columbia Catholic Ministry. Now, here's your weekly update from Father Dan O'Reilly.
October 23rd is the feast day of St. John of Capistrano, a Franciscan saint from the 15th century. He's famous, along with St. Bernardine of Siena, for creating devotion to the holy name of Jesus. You've probably seen what appear to be the letters I.H.S. on altars, on vestments, in churches, on prayer cards, but it's really not I.H.S. It's actually Iota, Eta, and Sigma, the first three letters in Greek in the name of Jesus. Why devotion to a name? Well, names are precious. God revealed his name to Moses in the book of Exodus, and his name was considered so holy that it wasn't even spoken. To this day, we're not really sure. Some people believe the name should be pronounced Yahweh. Other people believe it should be pronounced Jehovah. Even the name of Jesus is special. We know that it was revealed by the angel Gabriel to Mary. The name of Jesus was revealed to Joseph in a dream. St. Paul says that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. And popularity of this devotion grew very quickly. In fact, because of this devotion, they added the name of Jesus to the Hail Mary. And the practice of bowing one's head at the name of Jesus began at that time too. Popularity also spread due to a happy coincidence. St. Bernardine of Siena preached vehemently against gambling. He did it so much that a card maker in Bologna went out of business. And looking for help, he asked St. Bernardine what to do. So St. Bernardine of Siena said, well, instead of making cards for gambling, why don't you make prayer cards with the holy name? And the devotion spread very, very quickly. Names are precious. It's almost unbelievable that we're on a first name basis with God. We don't even have to call him Mr. Jesus. It's just Jesus. But more importantly, the holy name of Jesus reminds us that he knows our name. He's intimately close with us, and Jesus hears us whenever we call upon his holy name.